In this lecture, we'll cover a case of a rod sliding or falling. It is touching the floor. Right now it is vertical initially. It is allowed to fall, but when it falls, what happens? We should first imagine this floor. There is no friction. Friction is absent. So please be careful that in such problems, do not do like this. Do not do like this. That rod will fall like this. No, it doesn't happen like that. It happens only when the rod is hinged, or even if there is some friction. If there is no friction, this thing cannot happen. And suppose there is some friction, then it can move in different ways. It can fall gradually and also slide and also fall. But the center of mass can keep on shifting if there is friction. If there is some friction, then center of mass can shift horizontally. You can see not only center of mass is falling down, center of mass is also shifting its position. Please note the center of mass. Generally, in physics problems, we will have the horizontal movement or the vertical movement. We can have the components. And these movement of central mass only take place when there are forces acting on the body in that direction. So only if there is some horizontal force on the rod, only then the center of mass will shift horizontally. Now, if it's a completely smooth surface, the center of mass will not shift horizontally. This is the point I wanted to tell. It will just fall straight with center of mass straight, in the sense this will be the locus of center of mass. The rod will keep on falling, but center of mass, like after some time, the rod may have some position like this, making an angle theta, but the center of mass, you note, remains at the vertical location. So let us now find out in this case what would be the angular velocity of the rod when it has fallen to an angle theta with the horizontal. When it has fallen in such a way that it is making an angle theta with the horizontal. Now, what is the distance it has fallen? This height was L upon 2, and this height will be, this is L upon 2, this is theta. L upon 2 sine theta is this height. So what is the height fallen is L upon 2 1 minus sine theta is the height fallen, and the potential energy fallen will be mg times this height, and this will certainly get converted into the kinetic energy, and the kinetic energy is half mv square plus, you can see it has both rotational motion and translational motion. This is the velocity, but it also has a rotation like this. So it will also have the half I omega square. So it will have both the rotational and translational motion. Now, in such cases, you should try to see, can we find link between V and omega? Are these two linked? These will be linked because now you have a look at it. It is having some velocity V, which is I have taken. You have to take velocity of the center of mass here. Whenever you take the linear motion, please note the velocity of center of mass has to be taken. And this omega is the rotation. And this initial I is I center of mass. Don't take I at this point. I of the center of mass you have to take when you are talking about the rotational and the translational motion. Now, if you look at this, if the omega is the angular velocity for any body, suppose this is a rod, and if you have one velocity here and one velocity here, if this is v1 and this is v2, and they both are perpendicular like this. This is the axis and this is L. You can find the rotation omega for this. When these velocities are in opposite direction, you just add them. These will be equal to L times omega. And these have to be perpendicular. Suppose we had a situation like this, where this is not moving at all, but it is having some velocity like this, and this angle is theta. So you calculate V sine theta, and this will be V cos theta. Now rotation, if this rotation is in such a way that this part is not moving, say it was like this, it is hanging or somewhere, it is fixed. So now there is no velocity here. The velocity of the two ends, you see, the sum of the velocity of the two ends is V sine theta. Here there is no velocity. You divide it by L, you get omega. Now here apply the same thing, but be careful which one you have to apply. How do you look at it? Suppose now let me show you the mistake which can be committed here first, so that we don't commit those mistakes. Suppose I think that, okay, I'll find this component V, this is V, this was V downwards, this angle is theta, this is V cos theta. And I divide V cos theta by L upon 2 to find omega. V cos theta divided by L upon 2, I say that I will find omega, because this is L upon 2, this is V cos theta, but there is a mistake here. This rod is sliding like this. It will have some horizontal velocity also, and these V and VH will be linked, and therefore it will have some vertical component like this, vertical to the axis of the rod, not vertical to the floor. So finding the omega, you have to take sum of these two velocity divide by L upon 2. Or the other option could be here, if you take only the velocity, this velocity, and we are sure that rod is not moving vertically. There is no movement vertical. So velocity here, vertical component will always be zero. So you have two velocities. Here it is two ends basically, for you have to see at least two locations you have to see. And here now draw the perpendicular. The distance here is L upon 2 cos theta. This distance is L upon 2 cos theta. And this is V and this is 0, so omega will be V divided by L upon 2 cos theta. That is the correct method of finding out. I will also tell you how another method you would have got the same result. Now suppose I take this is V cos theta. There I told you that we should know this velocity also. Let this be V dash. Now what is V dash will depend on V horizontal. It will be V dash will be V horizontal sine theta, because this angle is theta, this is pi by 2 minus theta, so V dash will be V horizontal sine theta. What is V horizontal? Now you see, if this is y and this is x, x square plus y square are always will always be equal to L upon 2 whole square, in this case only, where there is no friction and center of mass is falling straight. So if you differentiate, it becomes twice x, x dot, plus twice y, y dot is equal to 0, or x, x dot is equal to minus y, y dot. X dot is the horizontal velocity I am trying to find, and x at this given point of time is L upon 2 cos theta VH is equal to minus sign just indicates that it is moving in this direction. Y is reducing, x was increasing, that is why this minus sign. I can avoid it just to see the magnitudes. Y was L upon 2 sine theta and VY is V. So you can see VH was coming as V sine theta upon cos theta is the VH. Now take the component of this perpendicular to the rod. VH was V sine theta, so it becomes V sine square theta upon cos theta. Now, what is this length? What add these two velocities? The resultant velocity will be this V dash plus V cos theta. It will be V cos theta plus V sine square theta upon cos theta. As I told you, you have to add, if there are two velocities in opposite direction here, one is this, another is this. So it becomes V upon cos theta when you solve it, because sine square theta cos square theta becomes 1. So this is the total resultant velocity, sum of the velocities of these two divided by L upon 2. You get omega is equal to V upon L upon 2 cos theta, which is same as which I have found out by another method. So I just showed you so that you have clarity in case in certain problem such situation occurs. Now you place the value of omega here and you can get the result.